Does anybody have any questions?
I'd like to ask Master, a few months ago, one person asked me quite a simple question. He asked me, Natalia, you keep saying about dancing and center of intuition, but why is it here and not in my elbow?
Actually, no center is correct center. So, originally, our true nature has no center. But we have this body, and we're very attached to our body. And the reason why the center's here is because it's here. Yeah. Actually, the baby's attached to its mom in this area. So everything for life is coming and going from this area. And even the baby's form is kind of growing around this place. So it just happens, you know, it's like, why can't you grow the talk? I mean, that's the same thing, because it's your mouth. Although you can communicate a lot with your elbow without using speech. So it just happens, that's it. But even if your center becomes strong, if you're not clear, then, you know, you become like Saddam Hussein or somebody like that. You know, dictators usually have very strong centers. Maybe Maggie's father has a strong center. You stand here. You know, a long time ago, I remember how in Mark, at least, I never heard Sun Tzu say this in Korea. He'd say, a long time ago, people understand each other. So if somebody does something bad, they would draw a circle and say, you stand there one day. And the person would stand there. And it was kind of a way to be shamed. And everybody knew you did something wrong. When I was in primary school, there was the principal's office. And next to the door was a bench. And if your teacher couldn't handle you, she would send you to the principal's office. And the office principal would make you sit on the bench. And, you know, so it was like, go to the bench. And it was supposed to be shame, because between classes and things, the kids would come and go, and they'd see that I'm on the bench, you know? But the truth is, yeah, some kids would be ashamed, but a lot of kids would be like, look at me, I'm on the bench. You wouldn't tell your parents that, but you and your friends are like, wow, he's on the bench. He's such a jerk. He's like, proud of it. So, you know, if nowadays, can you imagine in Russia, in America, maybe in Singapore they listen, but in America or something, draw a circle, tell you to stand there. It's like, maybe it would last 3 or 4 minutes while the police are there. As soon as they go away, it's like, somebody write something interesting in the circle and leave. So, you know, people had ways of, so somebody can be very strong, their center can be strong, but if they're not clear, then they make lots of problems. But somebody can have a very kind, compassionate mind. But if they're not strong, then many situations appear, they can't do it. Or how many of you have had like a boyfriend or a girlfriend at some point in your life and realized this isn't good anymore, you know? But your center's not so strong, so they come over and they're nice to you for like one moment and, well, you know, it's not that bad, you know? maybe it'll get better. So, or you really know you should stop something or do something, but your center's not strong, you don't do it. So that's a problem. So that's why we talk about the big question and just do it. You know, don't know and just do it. Even Juan Hill talks about wisdom and tri mind, like two wings of a bird. If you just have one, you can't fly. So, and you're sitting, all of you are sitting a lot, so you experience, without even thinking about it, you experience your energy. You know, and it's not worth thinking too much about your energy, I want to say. But, you know, sometimes it's all stuck up in here, your head's hot, you have a headache, or particularly people get tight here, they get tight in their back. Some people have problems with their stomach when they sit, stomach gets very tight. I remember hearing a story about the man who was the editor of the book Dropping Ashes, and he had been a monk with Sung San Sinim for about 3 years. And was a strong guy. He did a 100-day solo retreat, did 3,000 battles every day. You know, like Maggie said, this schedule, when there's a group, it's not that hard. I mean, it's hard sometimes, and sometimes you're tired and stuff. But everybody's going, so you get up and go. And then at some point through a day, you're like, wow, I can do this. And then a few hours later, it's like, so, but you see how you go in and out, in and out. So this man was a strong man, but one day early on, I heard that during an evening practice, he was complaining. You know, he didn't want to go to practice, and San Sinim went to see him. Because that time, if San Sinim was around, you had to go. He made everybody go. And of course, he was also sort of persuasive, too. And he, just being around him, you kind of got energy. So, you know, he had that personal ability. But this guy didn't want to go, so he said to the guy, why do you not come to practice? He said, my stomach's got a problem. So San Sinim said, lay down. Then I heard he took his hands and just shoved it into the guy's stomach really hard. The guy yelled, felt better, and came to practice. So I heard that. So one time during the first Gyoche I sat, also during an intensive week, my stomach got really tight. And I'm sure it was just some kind of emotional energy. But it was so tight and it hurt, and I'm like, I didn't want to go to practice. But then on one of the breaks, I said to one of my roommate, you know, I laid down, I said, would you take your fingers and push them in my stomach? And he did, and he pushed really hard. And suddenly I felt all this energy go out into my arms and legs. So we, by natural habit, and by the fact that we have a body, you know, energy gets stuck in various places. You know? And but if we try, and if we have a big question, that at some point these things release, often after we've given up caring anymore. You know? You're like, when's it going to go? When's it going to go? When am I going to feel better? When am I going to feel better? When am I going to feel better? You're never going to feel better if you keep thinking that way. Often, when you happen to forget about it, suddenly you feel a little better. You know, it's just like I'm sure most of you are coming. You know, every period, and there's some periods you don't want to be in this room. You know, but sometimes while you're sitting, you just all forget it, and it's okay. So our natural energy center just happens to be here, okay? But when we're born, it all moves up here. So you know, you've seen babies, you've been babies, but you probably don't remember. But babies, at a certain point, anything they grab, they'll stick in their mouth. So this becomes the energy center. And then, somewhere around one or two, it moves up here. Opposites thinking. So like a little baby doesn't think, I like it, I don't like it. They just do it. You put it in their mouth, and they're you put it in their mouth, they don't have any thinking, I don't like it. They just spit it out. Later, we have thinking. Then we see it, we already don't like it. So when anything's energy is up high, it's easy to knock down, and it's hard for that thing to come up. But if the energy is low, even if it gets knocked down, it's not so hard to come up. So when I was a kid, I think this was originally a Japanese doll or something, but in America they made one look like a clown. It was about a meter high, sort of shaped like a, you know, something, a cloud, and it had a sand in the bottom, so its center was very low. And you could knock it over, you know, little kids push it, jump on it, everything, and it would pop back up by itself. And I remember one of my favorite things when I got strong enough was to turn it upside down, jam its head in the ground, and then watch it float back up because of the weight. So when Sun Tzu talked about center, I remember that. Wow, if you have a center, even not just physically, but in social life, it can have a great effect. So one time I was living in France, and I was traveling with this teacher in the spring. For about 4 months, we would visit many, many cities, often three times a month, and do some teaching, run a workshop or retreat, come back to Paris. And then in the summer, I think it was June, July, and then in the autumn. So there were like three teaching seasons. And when I make the plan where we were going to go, then I would go to a travel agent and I would give them the list of everything and they'd make up the tickets. And in August, we always took a group of people to Hawaii for what was called a three-week retreat vacation. So everybody'd sleep in the temple, which was basically a big house, and had morning practice through lunch, afternoon free, so you could go to the beach, you could go around the island, you could go shopping, and then everybody gathered together for dinner and evening practice. So this really was like a retreat vacation. It was really cool. And one time I was taking about, I don't know, 20 people from France and Spain, and I went to the travel agent and gave her all the stuff, and we kept having to change things, and she was getting really irritated at me, you know, and I was getting irritated at her, and she couldn't find it on the machine and everything, and of course my energy was coming up, and I noticed it, and I just immediately brought it back down, and she said, suddenly she said, okay, I'll get somebody else, and this other guy came over and did the whole thing really quickly, but I was shocked. I just brought the energy down without saying anything, she also changed. So you can't think about things that way. Oh, I'm going to control that by bringing my energy down. All you can do is learn to deal with yourself. So Sun Tzu says a very interesting thing, and I repeat it over and over in the first three interviews. You know, at some point, we teach about energy. This is a, if you keep your energy here, many thinking, many desire, many suffering. If you keep too much energy here, too much emotion, then emotion control your mind. I like this, I don't like this. This person's good, this person's bad. That kind of thinking becomes strong. If you bring your energy down here, then you can digest your any opinion, any feeling, any situation. So this is your thinking center, emotion center, do it center. So, only go straight, don't know, when you're doing something, do it. Then your domo center will become stronger, stronger, stronger. Finally, this is the point I mean now. You can control your feeling, your condition, your situation. So Sun Tzu wasn't sloppy when he said things. If you want to control your situation, you have to be able to control your feeling and your condition. Otherwise, you'll never be able to control the situation. So that's why in Zen, one reason, we're looking back at ourselves. Your mind changes, your whole world changes. Your mind holds, your whole world is holding something. So we just, because we have a body, we use that teaching to help people balance, or what can we say, not put so much energy into opinions and emotions, okay? But if you don't have a big question, you don't digest it. You just become strong. Then wisdom, compassion doesn't appear. So both are necessary. But ultimately, no center is the correct center. Then no problem. That's why even Sun Tzu, he's very sick, he can barely breathe, but he was very, very clear, even at that time. You know? And because no longer dependent even on your body center, because our mind isn't dependent on our body if we practice well. Then your body is just giving you signs about things all the time, like it's hot, it's cold. If you know yourself well, when you get angry, you probably can figure out quite quickly why you're getting angry, which would give you some clue about the situation, which, if you have wisdom, can help you solve it. You know, many times we get into arguments with people, we don't even realize we're in an argument. One time, it was the woman I remember, one of Sun Tzu's strong students, very devoted and everything, and she heard about how in Korea, monks and nuns, also Catholic priests, have to fulfill their army service. So Sun Tzu, even after he was a monk, had to rest his precepts and go in the army during the Korean War. It's a Korean tradition that you support the country, even if you're a religious person. And so you literally rest your precepts so you're not held to those rules. And there's a way of doing that in Korean Buddhism. And that got her really upset. And she was like, how can Buddhist monks fight? You know, Buddhism's not about fighting. How can you do that? That's not correct. And then Sun Tzu, she kept going on and on, and then Sun Tzu said, look at you. Yes. That's not Buddhism, we're Buddhism. So, most important is see ourselves, understand ourselves, understand especially our true nature. Yeah. So anyway, it's here because it's here. But for many of us, it's not here. Look at the Middle East, everybody's screaming and yelling. Both sides look exactly the same. You look at a funeral, everybody's screaming and yelling and crying and throwing themselves on the coffin. Their energy's all up here, and they'll never stop it, ever, until some people, enough people wake up. So it's that way in any situation, and for us. So the only way to do that is to don't expect other people to solve the problems of